Hello everyone, and welcome to a new IBMI RPG sample video. Today, I'd like to talk to you about one of the new features that we have since version 7.5 and that we can now use if we have the corresponding PTFs installed. Today, I will talk about select and the new opcodes when in and when is. Let's go. As always, to edit my programs, I'm using VS Code and code for IBMI. As you know, you can download this programming environment and install this extension for free and start programming RPGle easily. I'm going to create a simple little program where I'm going to show how to use when is and when in. Okay, let me create a new source here. As in the rest of the examples that I usually do, this program will be a program without a cycle. So let me declare, first of all, it is going to be a cool-free program with only a main procedure. Main. Well, as you know, in these cases, when the execution of the main procedure ends, the program ends. So it is not necessary to activate the last record indicator. Okay. So let me declare some variables. Y. And well, let me initialize these two variables with this. Two values, for example, and this one. And now let me write the select. In this case, I can indicate an operand for the select. So I can write, for example, this. That means that we are going to make a select for the result of this operation. So if we have y equal to 2, then the operation is the result of the operation is 3. So we are going to use the number 3 as the operand for all the select. Okay. So of course this operand can be the result of an operation as in this case, but also can be a value, a variable, or the value returned by a procedure, okay? Then I can use the when in of code. And how is it? Well, the when in is asking if the operand, in this case, y plus 1, that is 3, is in, for example, a list. Let me write 1, 5, 7, 8. Okay, so this means that if the operand is in this list, this block will be executed. Okay, so the operand is in the list. In this case, I am writing a list, but also you can write a range, an array, or a subarray. Okay. Other thing that we can use is the when is opcode. When is. This is asking if the operand is some value. So for example, we can write is n. And this will mean that if the operand that is 3 is n, that is 5, so in this case it is they are not equal, then the block will be execute a operand and n are the same. Okay, but also we can write here a value. For example, we can write 3. operand is 3. Okay. And also I can use other for the rest of the options of the select instruction. For example. Okay, so let me compile the program and let's check how it works in the green screen. Okay, let's open a debug session. Let me stop it here and let me run it. Well, as y has the value of 2 and the result of 2 plus 1 is 3, then the operand is 3. So let's see which block is going to be executed. 3 is in this list? No. So it is not going to be executed. Is equal to n? No. So this is not going to be executed. Is equal to 3? Yes. Then this block is going to be run. Okay. So, well, as you can see, this new feature allows us to use operands with the select opcode. It is very similar to the switch and case of other programming languages. I hope you liked this video. Press like if so, and don't forget to subscribe to the channel. And as always, thanks for watching.